Please welcome the mayor of Milan, Giuliano Pisapia. Buonasera.
Buonasera a tutti, Presidente Barilla, amici e amiche, signore e signori. Posso dire che oggi per il Sindaco di Milano, in un momento difficile per tutti, è una bella giornata. Una bella giornata perché stamattina...
A lovely day for the mayor of Milan today, although it is not a very good time in general. It's been a long day. Late in the morning, I've been at the Statale University, where the honoris causa diplomas were awarded to Don Gino Rigoldi, Don Ciotti and Don Colmenia, three important Milanese characters. Of course, the applause is for them, not for me. Well, all these people talk about food every day. They talk about people, and they give a further contribution to our commitment to give out good food and good feeding habits to everybody. I am here today at the time where, after Mr. Renzi, our Prime Minister, has shared its contents, the Protocol of Milan is being given in the hands to Mr. Maurizio Martini, our Minister of Agriculture. And in the evening, I'll be dining with Don Colmenia and his people at the Casa della Carità, the House of Charity. All of this is very consistent. For a long time, Expo was mentioned only about its products, its site, of course. But what is remarkable now is that the commitment to speaking, to talking about themes of Expo 2015 is increasing. And just seeing you all here shows me that the consensus on the themes chosen for Expo 2015 by Milan is certainly growing. That's why I'm very pleased to be here, and I thank the Barilla Center for inviting me. We are now on the eve of a very important year for Milan. Expo is about to start, and I see a growing interest in talking, in discussing, and in finding shared objectives and actions to carry out in order to try and overcome an era where too many people have died of starvation in the world, where too many people do not have enough to eat every day, or on the other hand, where too many people are obese. The intervention of the executive chairman of the Barilla Foundation today shared with us some dramatic data. Over 1.6 billion people nowadays cannot receive the funds they would need with the contribution of the UN and all those who are fighting against those drama to they cannot be fed enough. So we must try and start from the processing of the Protocol of Milan to talk about these subjects, but especially to reach the objective so that all over the world, international organizations, but also individuals, not only sign the protocol which is presented today, but also commit themselves to transform it into something real and concrete. I am totally persuaded that the two initiatives, the one of the Barilla Center, which will also be presented at the European Parliament with the full support of the Italian government and hopefully soon by of many other governments. Well, all this should go together with the commitment taken by the city of Milan towards the other great cities of the world. We have two parallel paths which are continuously crossing over and which are in synergy. Last year in Johannesburg, the C40 meeting, gathering all the main cities in the world dealing with and committed with the global sustainability, I launched a call for action together with the environmental sustainability. We need food or access and sustainability, and the two things go together and require a common commitment. Data can confirm this. Over 50% of people in the world are living in great metropoles. 60% of the world territory will be represented by these megalopolis in the future. That's why the great world cities should become allies to our protocol, which should not only deal with environmental themes, but rather which should put at the very focus of its values the healthy nutrition and the fight against waste. The outcome is very encouraging. I think I can say, after these few months of work, that many great cities are already working with us, and some of them have already undersigned the first food policies among the great metropolis of the world. They belong to all sides of the planet, north, south, east, and west. And first the mayor of New York City and next the mayor of Moscow, at a few weeks' distance, said that they're both with Milan to take common steps forward. This is very important for Milan, especially if after these great cities, others will follow, and there is already an adhesion by Barcelona, Shanghai, Osaka, and many others. Many cities, and not only European ones, are ready and willing to go on and make progress towards these objectives. Milan has started already. It is good to discuss about these themes. I could feel the passion when Mrs. Pomodoro was dealing with this subject a minute ago. I remember the first conversation I had with Mrs. Pomodoro and with Mr. Giugiori, who was chairman of the lawyers of Italy. And we were wondering what could we do about Expo. And the idea came to their mind. We are talking so much about the right to food, and but too little is said and too little is decided among the governments about this right. There is so much said about it in general, such as the, for instance, the fight against forger, but not enough is put together. And university, the scientific committee of Expo, the city of Milan, and many experts, institutions, the deans of the main of all the Milanese universities are present together with the actual forces of the city. This is a guarantee to me. The subjects we shall deal with during the 6 months of Expo, which will be a sort of showcase, will go on, will be prosecuted even will be pursued even after the end of Expo. So there are some concrete things that a city can do in order to intervene on these subjects within, of course, its limits, starting from a child and up to the United Nations. It is a challenge which requires a new relationship between those who make, those who distribute, and those who use food and eat food. So this should make cities more smarter and smarter. Recently, an international ranking has seen Milan as the most advanced smart city in Italy. This is another step forward. Recently, Milan has made a lot of progress to become also the city where the quality of life is one of the best ones in Italy. But we must go forward and look after that. For instance, Milan is doing a lot as far as waste disposal is concerned. It is ranking very high in Europe. And then the case of water see as a common good, but also as a reason for fight in the world of the future. It is said, unfortunately, that there will be no more wars for oil, but rather for water. And then all the different brands of the agricultural produce around Milan, the urban gardens, as they are called, vegetable gardens, going to schools and seeing that there are little vegetables gardens in the cities, in the schools. Some school children have brought me some oil that they made from their own olive trees in their school. And this is also for a kind, this involves a sort of course, education from this viewpoint. We didn't have it in our generation, but now it is growing. And it requires the commitment of teachers, of institutions, of people in general to reduce the food waste. It is always important to start from little things. And the 80,000 children who get their meals every single day by Milano Ristorazione at school, each have their little box that they don't eat at school, and they bring it back home. Some of them out of need, they may not eat in the evenings if they didn't have that little box. Others because they have understood that it is necessary not to waste any food at all. And then also there is a retrieval of bread and fruit once it is known how many children exactly will eat at a certain school, in a cafeteria every single day. And instead shifted to the charitable institutions where long rows of people, most of them Italian also, unfortunately, is waiting. And I'm saying unfortunately because the needs of our population are getting more and more serious. The data is interesting. This year only 60 tons of bread and 100 tons of fruit have been saved somehow, and they have been redistributed to those who really needed them. Another initiative is adopt a grandfather or a grandmother. And children at schools now have the possibility of inviting a grandfather, or so an elderly person, at their table. And this is a good way of showing new initiatives. So the food policies of the greatest cities in the world will follow those orientations. We shall also go beyond, but what is necessary is to start from little things. I wish to thank you all for being here, as well as all those who are working and will work for what cannot be an utopian thought, but an objective that we can reach if we work together. Thank you very much.